Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be telling you guys about a cryptocurrency called RaiBlocks, or maybe it's called RaiBlocks, but I'm going to call it RaiBlocks. And I'll be telling you everything you need to know in very simple language about this cryptocurrency. So don't you go anywhere. Welcome back. So let's get straight into talking about RaiBlocks. What is RaiBlocks? RaiBlocks is purely a cryptocurrency with nothing else attached to it. So it's just like Bitcoin. It's just purely crypto, and it's currently ranked number 20 on CoinMarketCap, and it currently has a market cap of about $2.8 billion, and it's trading right now at around the $20 mark. RaiBlocks' mission is to tackle the scalability problem. They want to accommodate over 7,000 transactions per second, as we can see here. Bitcoin do about 7, Dash do about 10, Ripple over 1,500 transactions per second, but then RaiBlocks are scaling higher than that, yo. Like, they want to do over 7,000 transactions per second. To achieve this, RaiBlocks is going to use an infrastructure called the Block Lattice, where each account has its blockchain called an account chain. So every transaction you do will be stored in your personal blockchain. Like in Bitcoin, everyone has to wait at least an hour. Some people even wait for days if they don't want to pay high transaction fees, because all your transactions have to be approved by the miners before they can be stored on the blockchain. But in RaiBlocks' case, it's truly peer-to-peer. I mean, this is not to say Bitcoin is not peer-to-peer. Of course it's peer-to-peer, but then you have the miners, and in RaiBlocks, you don't have the miners. So I send RaiBlocks straight to you without needing any miners to confirm any transactions. Now let's have a look at what the Block Lattice looks like. This is the infrastructure that RaiBlocks is using to achieve this. So as you can see, in RaiBlocks, every transaction requires a sender and a receiver transaction. So for a transaction to be completed, two new blocks have to be created. Each transaction is a small block. So the sender transaction is a block, and the receiver transaction is also another block. So here, if Alice on the left here wants to send some RaiBlocks to Carly, she would create a block, which is the sender transaction, as you can see above her head here. And then Carly will have to create another block to receive that transaction. So if Carly does not create a block to receive the transaction, this transaction will not be completed. It will just be left hanging. Also, Carly has to confirm the transaction by signing that the RaiBlocks Alice sent has been received by her. And then the transaction gets recorded on the network. Same for if Bob, my friend, down at the bottom here, wants to send Carly a transaction. You see the time here on the left? It shows you that the transactions don't have to be in real time. So if we go back to Alice and Carly's transaction, you can see that it's not a straight line. That means that even if Carly's offline at that time, Alice can still send the transaction. And whenever Carly gets online, she can create her own block and then receive the transaction. And then the transaction will be completed. And if you look at the transaction down on the right between Bob and Carly, you can see that Carly was probably online when Bob created a send transaction, and she was able to create a receive block almost immediately to receive the transaction. So now you're thinking, how is this even secure? Like, how can I create my block and how can you create your block and we transact between each other? Anything can happen on the network, right? There's nodes on the network just chilling and just watching everything that's going on. So say for example, somebody tries to double spend. That's when the nodes chime in, like, what is going on here? You know, it's just like when policemen are waiting at the police station and then they get a call out if there's something happening, like a robbery somewhere or something like that. So yeah, the nodes are just chilling. So they don't chime into anything on the network until they sense something is going wrong. Also, RaiBlocks use the delegated proof of stake voting. So if you hold some RaiBlocks and there's something going on in the network, you can vote on which transaction is right or which transaction is wrong. And the more RaiBlocks you own, the more power you kind of have on, you know, to speak on the network. The only setback that I see here is dishonest people just going in and staking so high and voting to confirm yes to transactions they're fully aware is wrong, or even transactions that they've planted by themselves, like a scam really. So when it comes to the spam and the security of the network, RaiBlocks have a number of ways listed on their website of how they're going to tackle these attacks. I mean, their white paper is only 7 pages. It's one of the shortest white papers I've ever seen in the cryptocurrency world. So I definitely recommend you guys having a look. It's only 7 pages. So yeah, your website is pretty easy as well. There's not that much technical jargon on the website. It's one of the most straightforward cryptocurrencies ever. Seriously, it is. And up till now, they haven't had any attacks on the network. Not that I've heard of. And the good thing about RaiBlocks is that there's no fees involved. The fees in cryptocurrencies right now are becoming so annoying. I'm not even gonna lie. It actually does annoy me that sometimes I have to pay between 7% and 10% of however much I'm sending. Like, why? I mean, the whole point of cryptocurrency is to cancel out these fees, right? So why we gotta pay so much money? So there's no fees in RaiBlocks and the transactions are almost immediate. RaiBlocks have a wallet that you can download and they're also working on a mobile wallet. So if you want to buy some RaiBlocks, you can get them via KuCoin Exchange. And sorry, Binance lovers, Binance doesn't list RaiBlocks just yet. Maybe in the near future, who knows? I mean, I wish Binance were listed as well, so I didn't have to open an account on KuCoin. But yeah, I'll link KuCoin down below. This is in no way, shape or form investment advice. I'm not telling you to go all out there and exchange all your money for RaiBlocks. All I'm doing is just sharing knowledge, period. So yes, I'm very thankful for reaching 100 subscribers. I can't believe that 100 people want to hear what Little Me has to say. I mean, I couldn't fit 100 people into this room, so that's a massive number to me. And I see you guys as my friends. So thank you very much for subscribing. Thanks for your comments. Thanks for all the questions. I engage so much in the comments and it actually does make my day that you guys are watching my videos and you guys are understanding everything I'm talking about. So yes, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up again, leave a comment in the section below. Let me know what you think about RaiBlocks and let me know if you have any questions. Follow me on my social media, especially my Instagram and my Twitter, because I put updates out there. And if you're new here, click the subscribe button and I will see you on my next video. Bye guys.